Where you are right now, what was that defining moment for you that let you know that this is where you need to be. And by where you need to be, I'm not necessarily referring to the physical or geographical location, but Yoshi Barnes, CEO of Support My Fitness, able to get up every day, train people, do what it is that you love. How did you know that this was your calling?
My absolute honest answer is, I've said this to my nieces and nephews all the time, my relationship with God is critical to me. And the more that I would invest into talking to him, he would give me all this insight, and he would just, for being obedient, he would bless me with something. And that's where I'm saying, every single time I do right by him, I receive something. I receive money. Money's not an issue. Right. I receive clientele. I receive so much opportunity and resources that just come from out of nowhere.
Absolutely.
So I'm like, golly, like, this is exactly what I'm supposed to be doing. And anytime I've tried another way, I've tried other things, I've not been successful at it.
Right.
You can only get so far without him. But with him, I've been able to progress. And he's shown me, like, that's what it is. And so I wake up every day inspired by what he's told me I could have. And I'm like, it's mine. I gotta go get it, you know. And throughout, my motivation has changed. Your whys and what inspires you will change. And that can be yearly, that can be weekly, or daily even.
Right.
But what's going to propel you forward has always been, like, now my relationship with God.
Okay. So let's talk about the potential daily change of motivation, or the daily change of why. Anyone who has accomplished anything, and they've likely gone through some type of struggle or some type of period in time where discouragement was higher than it should be. What is it that keeps pushing you when you have those moments where you're like, is this really it? Is this for me? Or you wake up one morning like, why the hell am I still going?
Yeah.
What is it that's just tugging at your heart that's making you continuously push through no matter what?
What I know can relate to other people is, like, when you're younger, it's like your situation and your circumstances and where you come from. Mm-hmm. And, like, that was number one that, like, motivated me. I'm like, dude, I don't want to be in Milwaukee like this. Like, I want to progress and I want to move forward. And that's all I used to think about, and that's what got me to college, right? But when you're in college, you're not there no more.
Right.
So your family and your home doesn't inspire you or motivate you that much.
Right.
But then I hear people who tell you you can't. So I'm in college and people would say, like, you're from Milwaukee, or I would tell them I wanted to be a lawyer. And they're like, you're not smart enough. And so to prove somebody wrong was another reason. And not let somebody say to me, like, break me. It was more of like, you know what, whatever, I'm going to do it anyway just so, you know, I can show or prove to you that I'm better than what you put the expectation on.
Right.
And then after you graduate from college, it's still, I don't even know what I want to do. I'm not a lawyer, so it's now I want to try to figure that out. I'm going to wake up every single day and try to figure that out. But first I started with figuring me out. And then just the same, I started training. I was working in corporate America, working at YMCA, LA Fitness, and I was not able to grow in environments.
Right.
Like, I wasn't making no money, and so the discouragement came when people would say, you need to just quit. You got your degree, why don't you go to law school? Why don't you go do this? And guess I quit. I quit a couple times, you know? And usually it's because of the closest people to you are the ones that will discourage you, and not on purpose. You know, the ones that you really love are just throwing out things like, well, maybe you should find something else to do.
Right.
Or, you know, training is only bringing in 200 or something. You know, you're not even training a lot, or people can't afford it, it's too expensive. And so I became a paralegal, and I was extremely unhappy because I knew I had something in me that I needed to give away and change someone's life. I am here to serve, and I get more enjoyment out of that. So sitting behind the desk, I'm like, dude, I'm walking, getting up, doing lunges to the bathroom. I'm like, I can't sit here.
I've been there before.
You know,
I've been there before.
I can't. So I quit that job, and I was like, I'm going to start my own business. And someone was like, you can't do that either. And I'm like, why? Because you don't have the credentials. You ain't got. I just started zoning people out. And I'm like, you know, I'm going to do this. And that's why I was like, God, we start praying more. My relationships with him started to, like, kind of like grow. And then my success starts to happen. And then I'm inspired by the life changes and my service. So that is fulfilling to me. Like Shannon, my last client, you know, she has a situation, she's going through something very similar to something that I've been through. And to share with her how I just got out of it is inspiring to her. So she excited about coming back on Thursday.
Absolutely.
And I'm like, that's why I'm good, and that's why I can wake up some days and still do it, work out all day, be tired. But if I wake up and be like, come on, God, give me a little bit of life.
I saw that from you, and I was just sitting back, keeping the scene, and I was like, you know, it's Monday morning. Early as hell, well, to some people, early as hell, those of us who like to get up and enjoy the grind, it's nothing.
Right.
But I was very inspired by the amount of energy that you were still able to instill, not only in your client, but it was infectious energy towards me too. And that just, I think that's a testament to someone that's actually living and walking in their purpose.
You have to believe it too.
Absolutely.
Like, you have to believe, like, this is who I am. And also, as a trainer, when I leave out here, I need to be the same person. Mm-hmm. I do know a lot of people in our community are not, they don't match up sometimes.
Right.
Some people do, some people don't. But I want to match up. I want to be the, if I'm going to eat right, I don't want people seeing me walking down the street eating pizza all the time. I can't be slap drunk, and I can't be that way.
Right.
I have to be who I say I am. Who I wake up and say I am, this is the same. Applies, everything applies.
Definitely. So take us into that moment where, you know, you were sitting at that desk in corporate America, and that moving moment, whether, you know, whether it was God talking to you or whether you just had that gut feeling that said, you know what, I'm just gonna quit. Take us through a journey of what was going on in your mind at that pivotal moment when you decided, I'm going to quit. Because there might be someone there watching right now who, and we're not encouraging anyone to, you know, just quit your job if you don't have anything lined up and, you know, you're just going off on a whim. There has to be some calculated risk to it, but I'm pretty sure that some of you might be watching this and are in a similar situation that Yoshi was in, or a similar situation that I've been in before. Take us through that journey in your mind when you made that decision, said, I'm gonna quit, I'm gonna do my thing, I'm not worried about what anybody else is saying anymore, I'm staying in my lane. Because we also talk about how comparison is the deep of joy.
Oh my God, yes.
Take us through that moment.
Okay. So the first, like if I say you learn who you are first, because then you'll start to feel like you deserve something better than what you've been given.
Right.
If you love yourself so much, you'll start to want to accept other things. You know, you'll accept somebody telling you that you can't if you don't love yourself
enough.
And so I'm like, I would sit there and think, if I really do love myself, and I don't know why we're taught not to love ourselves, or not in a selfish way, not in a conceited way, but enough
the healthy way.
First. And then I'm like sitting there, like, okay, well then, like, forget what other people are talking about. What is it that you want? Because this is who you are. How can you use it? You start questioning yourself. And then to go sit, I work with legal offices.
Right.
I'm like, okay, I can just sit down and talk to him and meet with him and see. How did he get in this position?
Right.
Seeking out information. And we sat down and we talked, and that hit home with me too, because I'm like, I'm not even like you. I'm not like you. I don't come from where you come from.
Right.
So I want to do something that people feel like we cannot do. Mm-hmm. We can't start our own businesses and we can't be successful at them.
Absolutely.
And I'm like, wow, like, you know what? I'm just gonna go do it and be that person.
I appreciate that.
I'm gonna be different from anybody. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna do what people are not gonna do. Sacrifice, being broke, blessings, or whatever, you know. And it's every single day is figuring it out and understanding that you don't have it, you don't have to have it all figured out. But today, whatever it is that's necessary, I'm gonna do that.
Right.
And then I made a commitment to me to say, this is what I'm gonna do. It's for me, it's not about them, it's not about your mom.
Mm-hmm.
Me and my mom were best friends, and she was one of the people like, you go get another job. I'm tired of you asking me to borrow $20 of gas. I'm like, you're right, mom. But we love each other, and now that's not her intent for me to be unhappy, but I have to learn not to listen to her either.
Mm-hmm.
You just gotta listen to your greater self. Like,
indeed.
Your greater self.
Still voice within.
Yeah, and it talks constantly, and fear will always stop you. Like, fear is gonna stop every single person that's fear is doing its job. Fear is supposed to scare you. It's supposed to say, you know you. But you are so much more than that, that if you just beat fear up one time, you will be okay. And then you can continue to just move forward and believe it.
Yeah.
You know, I believe this to the utmost power, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I believe in it.
And fear definitely can be a bully sometimes.
Yeah.
I was reading a book last night about reinventing himself. And one of the main things that he was saying was to pay attention on why you're making certain decisions. If you're making a decision based on fear, then that's probably not the right decision for you. But if you're making a decision based on growth, then that's probably going to lead you to where you're
being
going.
Bold.
Indeed. Yeah. So I'm glad Yoshi Barnes has arrived at this moment, and which has brought us Sport My Fitness. And I appreciate that, because I know a lot of people out, you know, in our community are able to benefit from the services that you provide as well. So quickly, tell us about Sport My Fitness, you know, how the name came about, what all services do you provide, and you know, how people can take advantage of it.
Okay, so Sport My Fitness is my mission in this is to elevate and to empower and to encourage people to better their lives physically and mentally. And I do that by providing a service within organizations. I go into schools and big businesses to bring them more of a health and a wellness awareness, and how they can propel not only with themselves physically but mentally as well, and growing in other areas in their lives. So that's where Sport My Fitness came about. Sporting who you are is like wearing who you are. You wear your confidence, you wear your self-esteem, you rock, you know, who you are. Like your energy, people can feel that, and I wear that. So that to me was Sporting My Fitness, and that's kind of where that name came about. And then I started off personal training. And then, so growth, personal training isn't enough. You know, that wasn't enough to one-on-one work with somebody and charge them this amount of money. And so entrepreneurship and a business owner mind take hold, and I start to think a little differently. So now this is a business, so how can I grow this business? There is a branch to this. So now I've provided people with a personal training service that either is one-on-one, private time, or you can do groups of 2 to 3 people, and then I also have classes as well where they're large groups of people, 10 to 15, 20 people.
Okay.
And that is how I can touch people through just my service of working out. And then I've had the opportunity to create a life fitness class. It's something that a curriculum that I've implemented into a few different schools, where we lecture and then we work out. And it's all about, it's a connection and correlation, for an example, focus. So we lecture for 30 minutes where I'm talking to these kids about what it really means to be focused and what it really means to lock in. That's our definition for the week.
Right.
Now I want to apply this to exercise and how we can maintain a focus in achieving results. Mm-hmm. And so kids benefit from that, because I'm not just sitting and lecturing them, but we can also get up and move, and then I interact with them. They're more likely to get involved. So I have 3 different schools. I've been fortunate enough to send interns to go out and teach these classes for me. That's just another stem to this umbrella. And then another thing I've done, and so I'm like, okay, I love large audiences of people. I don't want to just be in this small space and talk to 1 or 2 people.
Right.
I want big audiences. So what I've done is create events, and they're all health events. I just had a fitness palooza party that was cracked, 9 o'clock at night. I wanted to change that whole, we can go party in the club and drink, but hey, we can come party and jump around in the gym and get fit and laugh.
I love it.
And it was a great success, and that was awesome. I've done women's empowerment events, 60, 70, 80 women. Just being on a panel, just discussing health and wellness with them, and going for walks. I have a mom and me event that's coming up for mothers and their kids.
So August 12th, right?
Yeah, so I'm just trying to put myself in positions to be in larger, because I know that I have something valuable, and I want to give that away. That's my job. And so after the events came, there's so much other things that I can walk into now. I can walk into apparel, where now I have this for my fitness gear, and I'm working on pants and shoes and hats and all these other things. So that's just a step to this umbrella, and I'm just going to continue to grow this thing. I've had the opportunity to work with professional athletes and basketball players, which led me to coaching the Milwaukee Aces, a semi-professional basketball team. And so this umbrella for Sport My Fitness is just continuously growing. And now I'm at this place of elevation that I'm just one person. I can't do all this myself. And this is where now you need to learn how to add and extend, and the right people need to come, and you need to be conscious of who you're giving things,
absolutely,
you know, giving away to people, and learning how to ask for the right things, and learning how to delegate people to get things done for you. And that's just where I am. And I've been continuously growing, and now that I'm walking through this process, I love to share that with someone who's possibly working in, you know, the WAC, but he works part-time and then has a whole other job.
Right.
And like, I've been there too. But if you really love this and you want to learn how to develop it full time, I'm the perfect person to talk to about it because I've done it and I'm doing it and I'm still walking in my growth. And the more focused that I am, opportunity is just coming left, right.
I love it. Yeah, that's very inspirational to me. And then, you know, I also, as a DJ and a certified personal trainer through the National Academy of Sports Medicine, that fitness palooza thing,
yeah.
I want to talk to you about that.
Okay. We about to actually take that to another city. I'm working on doing it in New Orleans.
Okay, okay.
Opportunity, guys.
Yeah, so I definitely want to hear more about that later. Yeah. Definitely. Okay. So for somebody who might be watching this right now and they just need some advice or they need some type of inspiration to get up and go do it. Mm-hmm. What's one piece of advice you can leave for the people right now?
Literally, my slogan is really you gain, you maintain, or you lose. And that could be, you can relate that to fitness. I gain weight, lose weight, I maintain what I have. Mm-hmm. And that can apply to life. I'm here to gain something in life. I'm here to get rid of and lose something in my life. I'm here to maintain my success in life. And it all takes work. And I think in some of our communities, when you hear hard work, it's related to a negative connotation for some reason. But I am so in love with what I'm doing that hard work is nothing to me,
right.
You know? And I'm willing to do it. I'm willing to gain. I'm willing to lose out on friends and whatever situation, party, and I'm willing to sacrifice. And my maintenance of myself and my life, I'm willing to do that every day because it's not easy maintaining this either. And it takes work. Fall in love with the process. And then you'll become more successful. But wake up every single day knowing that you are worth it and you are enough to go and get it. That's what it says in the back of church.
What does it say?
I am enough.
I am enough.
Yeah.
You are enough. Indeed. Yeah. Wouldn't be right. I wouldn't be DJ Adamocity if I didn't sprinkle in some music into this. I heard you, getting your groove on when I was waiting for the interview. So on a perfect day at Sport My Fitness, yeah. Or when you out, you about to have the best workout. What you listening to? What you listening to get you pumped up or to get your clients pumped up?
The first thing I do in the morning, though, I'm always listening to like Eric Thomas, Steve.
Okay.
I'm listening to these people that's gonna inspire me to say, you know, I wake up every day and I say, I am. That gives me geek.
Pound the pavement, yeah. Kind of motivation.
Yes, I love motivation. I love daily devotionals. Music-wise, I'm a Chris Brown fan.
Okay.
So anything that he plays gets me pumping. I'm all about it. That's just kind of where I am with music. Anything that'll give me to like kind of bob my head to jump around.
Okay.
I like that.
Cool. So for those of you who don't know what the word futuristic actually means, future is a hybrid of the word view and future. So we at Viewturistic believe that how you view your future is what your future is going to be, so long as you put in that dedication and that commitment to aspire to make your dreams come true. So let's say that Viewturistic was able, or let's say we had a magic paintbrush,
okay.
And we could give it to Yoshi Barnes, and 5 years from now, you could paint the perfect picture of whatever you want your life to be, whatever you want Sport My Fitness to be.
Yes.
What would that picture look like?
It would be longevity. It would be solid, a solid foundation, life-changing, people that are inspired. I want to sit on Ellen's couch and just share with her, like, and be excited, like, what's good, Ellen?
I can't wait.
She always dances, and I'm like, I want to dance with Ellen.
Yeah, yeah.
Joy, happiness. I want to be able to travel and not be so confined to one area.
Yeah.
So that paintbrush would be me talking to thousands of people on stage with Mike. I'm over in Italy and Spain and Greece. Doing what I love to do there, and that's empowering, and that is motivating people all over the world, and that's smiling, being energetic, and then just pray it up, happy, you know?
Pray it up.
Yeah, happy.
Cool, thank you for that. I can't wait to see all that stuff takes place, because I'll be able to say, I was right here, I caught you right before you did all that. So before I let you go, any last piece of advice to the viewers?
I do. I'm constantly posting motivational things, inspiring things, my upcoming events. If you guys want to check me out on Facebook, you can find me under Yoshi Barnes. That's YOSHI. My last name is Barnes, BARNES. And then Sport My Fitness. And then also, if you guys want to check out my website, as long as I'm on.
We'll give y'all the link.
I'll give it to you. It's www.sportmyfitness.wix.com/personal training. And then you can go in there and you can get any updates and information about my future things and anything that I got going on. And also, you can find me on Instagram under Yoshi Barnes as well. And then through social media, I wanted to be that change. So if you want to follow somebody that's motivating and inspirational, that can inspire you through your journey, then definitely add me and follow me on these sites.
Indeed. Y'all make sure y'all go find Yoshi. If you're looking for a personal trainer, if you're looking to have a good time while you are doing it, I definitely endorse Miss Yoshi Barnes as that person to go and get that from. And like I said, we'll provide those links below. So thank you once again for allowing me to come through to your space. Thank y'all again for tuning in. As always, if you have any questions or if you have any suggestions, recommendations, you just want to get in touch with us, make sure you reach out to us at our Gmail. That's theviewture@gmail.com. And as most of you know, those of you who have been watching for a while, I do give out my phone number at the end of every video because I am very reachable. So if you want to shoot me a text message, give me a call. If you need some inspiration, if you want me to connect you with Yoshi, make sure y'all shoot me a text message, give me a call, 414-292-7258. And always remember, if you can view it, you can do it. Until next time, peace out.